I was about to say something.
Nah.
He says nah to the exit. Okay, so that's the book then. Oh, well. She has it, I think. So she changed the password because Gavin knew the password. So instead, she changes the password to something having to do with a book he gave her and puts a post-it note on her computer. I mean, I guess she figured he'd never come back in here and use her computer. She just didn't want to get to, you know, things, her online stuff from his computer, but still, should have been a little more, you know, what do you call it? A little safer with that? Didn't seem like a good idea. How do I do this?
Nah.
Oh, now I can put in the keyboard.
I resent having to pay special delivery for train tickets, but I need them today. The next train isn't for 2 weeks. I can't wait that long.
Train tickets to
what? The site says it was delivered and signed for.
By
I don't recognize that signature, and even I would have remembered signing for it today. Looks like it says Benwood or something? What? Well, great. Fucking perfect. I need those tickets. Maybe it's a mistake. Maybe they'll still come. Maybe the website's fucked. It's too late to call them now. What else can I do but wait?
Benwood?
Now it's storming. This is gonna be fun, making my way to the station by midnight. I'm not being sarcastic. I just want the tickets to get here. Guess I'd better find a way to spend my evening then. Don't feel like playing a game, so maybe a DVD is in order. Might make a change.
Looking outside, it seems like the storm's hit a little early, New York. Rain, thunder, lightning, the works. So batten down those hatches and get ready for a cozy musical night in with me, Kenna Martin, exclusively on BC 304 FM.
So Benwood. Someone Benwood.
Ah, the sofa. Wait. Sure, yeah.
There was someone just there. Alright, so we want to get a DVD then. From here, because that's locked for some reason. These are not DVDs. Alright, maybe I want to look for a key?
It can't be locked. It doesn't even have a keyhole.
Oh.
It must be jammed. I think I can jimmy it open with something, if I can find something that'll fit.
The phone?
I'm not calling her or anyone else. Not tonight.
What? Can we jimmy something open with?
If I was drinking, but I...
What was in here again?
I should leave the plant alone now. There's nothing useful in there, I'm pretty sure.
So we're going to get in the kitchen?
Unfortunately, Gavin took all the cutlery with him, so I'm having to make do with brittle plastic crap. It won't be any use. The more I think about that, the more it pisses me off. Who takes the fucking forks when they go? Seriously.
Yeah, really.
The kitchen. Unfortunately, Gab won't be any...
Well, maybe you can even take a plastic knife and just jimmy that thing open.
Books gained?
Maybe the inhaler?
Nah, let's knock it.
A book?
I haven't thought... I'm sick. I can't... since I have... By applying, I'd love to, as shown in. I'd prefer to leave it on. My DVD collection. I think a few.
My colleagues keep telling me I need a vacation, and I say to them, guys, you get the same pay packet as me. Do you think I can afford a vacation? I think they're just trying to get rid of me. I'm joking, of course, to all the wonderful people at BC 304 FM. You're my family now. Wow, what a chilling thought.
Talks a lot for a DJ. Can we use this?
You know what? I think this little guy's tail would fit in the gap.
Awesome.
This idea is so stupid that it might just work.
Yeah. Beggars can't be choosers.
A memento. Gavin won this for me in one of those claw machines. No idea how he did it. Here goes.
Here goes.
It fits perfectly. Oh shit. The tail's just snapped off.
Oops.
Well, this was one of my better ideas, wasn't it? Fuck's sake.
Huh.
Oh.
That's all you had to do. What is the with the thing at the... Does that mean anything when it flashes red at the top there?
Right. Let's see what we have here. Photo of me and Gavin. It's broken. I put it here out of the way.
Garbage.
And here are the DVDs. Don't really care what I watch. I'll just stick some crappy horror on.
And someone's gonna be watching it with you. Because there was just someone on that couch. Is she asleep? 1 hour later.
Huh? Shit. Fell asleep.
Yeah, I was gonna say, it's an odd position.
On 8. Phone's ringing. Better answer the phone.
Guess we're all gonna answer the phone.
Better answer the phone. Better answer the...
Yeah, she's not gonna listen to anything.
Better answer the phone.
Okay, answer the phone.
Hello? Gavin? Oh, Rob, hi. What's up? Oh, really? That's brilliant. Oh, thanks so much. Thank you.
What's that?
That was Rob, my neighbor from the apartment down the hall. He has my package.
Oh.
The delivery man signed it and left it with him. He's bringing it over now. I'm just... Shit. I'm doing this. I have to get ready. Shit. Yes.
His name was Ben something.
What now, Rob? Forgotten where I live? Better answer the phone. Hello? Yes? This is Alex Davenport speaking. I... Thank you.
Gavin's dead?
I can't breathe. I can't fucking breathe.
Shit. Oh god. Inhaler. Did that help? First thing that came to mind, really. Rob?
Hey, Alex. Jesus, how bad is this storm? Oh, hey, are you all right?
I'm fine. Thanks. Fine. I just had a bit of bad news. I'll be fine. Sorry, Rob.
Ah, oh, God. Gavin again?
Nah, nothing to do with him this time. Sorry.
Mom died?
It'll be all right. I just need to sort some stuff out. Bad times. You know how it is. Hey, look, thanks for bringing this over.
Dad died?
You sure?
No. Yeah. Seriously, I'll be fine. Thanks, Robert.
You only call me Robert when you're not okay, Al. I know you like your own company, but seriously, you know where I am if you need me.
Yeah, I do. And honestly... Honestly, tomorrow you're gonna have me sniveling on your doorstep begging you to listen, but right now I just need...
Nah, it's okay, Al. Take all the time you want.
He sounds very familiar. He sounds familiar.
I won't be here tomorrow. Sorry, Rob, I'll call you. Please don't worry about me. I don't want to think about anything right now. Days are endless. I need to get ready to leave. There's always tomorrow. I'll call Mom tomorrow, too.
What's the bad news? It's not about Mom. It's not about Gavin. What'd she do? Put the inhaler down there? Or the tickets?
Outside, the city begins to withdraw. A siren sounds in the night, blue light reflecting on brickwork as tireless paramedics rush to the scene of another trauma. On the pavement below, a woman hurries home, casting furtive glances over her shoulder as she pulls her coat tight around herself, the rain beating patterns on the fabric. A car drives past, music disturbing the peace. The woman looks at the man in the car. He turns the music down, calls something out as he passes. I see the woman start to walk faster. She flinches at the thunder. The car drives off. Another set of sirens now. Somewhere in the distance, the city is drowning. This is where we live. This is our world. Ebb and flow, endless, forever. It's the perfect time for loneliness. The perfect time to indulge the selfish, petulant monologues of the dispossessed. But sometimes it's just like this, you know? Sometimes we can't help it. Sometimes we don't want to go out and hang out with your friends. Sometimes we don't want to talk. Sometimes we just want to wallow. You don't know me. You never fucking knew me. Go fuck yourself, you judgmental, self-righteous prick. Cat, I'll see you soon.
Who's Cat? We haven't mentioned a cat before. Is that who she's going to see? Cat? I saw that. No long sleeve
like
shirt.
The storm didn't reach here. The snow is still falling. It's a clean, crisp night. Just past midnight. The train should be here any moment.
Hope so, anyway. Harold Ling. So what is this bad news, and who is she going to see? I assumed it was Gavin, but...
This place is lonely and forlorn. Took an expensive cab ride to get here. We're in the middle of nowhere. The station looks like it hasn't been used in years. There's nobody inside and it's all boarded up. No point. Just gone midnight. Feels like I've been here forever.
He must be freezing.
It's a bit too big to carry around.
I didn't want to take you to take the clock.
Train tracks. They don't look very well maintained. I probably shouldn't start playing on the tracks. A forest. The trees are bare in the winter months. I've never been here before. I should explore when I'm back from Augur Peak. I used to love walking in the forest with Mom and... Yeah, maybe I'll go walking in the forest when I'm back. Although I imagine there are plenty of forests on Augur Peak to explore.
That's right, she's going to Augur Peak for something.
I can't go off exploring forests right now. The train's coming.
Distance?
I can't see the train. I hope it shows up soon. I'm freezing.
She used Gavin's coat.
I'm not walking away. I'm here now. There's no turning back.
Look at the light. So we got this Harold Lang, who apparently she knows because that's his name, right?
A pile of luggage, including mine. I just dumped it there because it seemed like the right thing to do. The porter can get it when the train pulls in.
Guess there's nothing left but to talk to... Oh, I've got a whole bunch of crap! Never mind, I will look at my inventory.
My cracked little doggy. My cracked little...
Doggy.
My train tickets. Cards, money, mace, the usual. My trusty lighter, 10 years old and still going strong.
Pack of Morleys?
I'd like to say smoking is my only vice, but it's not. The Charnel House Burial. I don't remember bringing this.
You grabbed it to get the password for the computer. Okay, there's nothing else.
An intellectual-looking guy. His jacket has elbow patches. Cool.
Alright, so I guess we don't know who he is.
So...
yet.
Have you been waiting long?
I'm not sure. I lost track of the time.
Tell me about it. I nearly slept through tonight. There's a clock over there, though.
It hasn't moved since I got here.
Oh. Great.
So, where are you headed?
A little port town. Last stop.
Me too. I'm not staying there, though. Catching the ferry to Augur Peak Island.
Yeah, me too.
It's not a common destination, is it? What brings you to the island, if you don't mind me asking?
It's dumb. You'll laugh.
Tell us.
I'm headed there to dig around in the dirt and check out broken pots. Trust me, I won't laugh.
Archaeologist?
Okay, fine. It's a bit of a personal pilgrimage.
Ah, I won't pry any further. But, you know the funny thing?
What's that?
It feels that way to me, too.
Right on cue.
Train should be here soon. I think I can see it.
I think I can hear it.
It's going to be a long, boring journey. Fool that I am, I forgot to bring any recreational reading material.
Yeah, my Charnel
House. All I have to pour over are some historical texts. Thrilling.
Give him the book.
An intellect.
Hey.
I guess I should let go of it. I won't need it after tomorrow. Just one final reminder of Gavin I can do without.
True.
Hey.
Hey.
You can take this. I've already read it.
Pulp horror fiction?
Yeah. Sorry.
No, not at all. It's my guilty pleasure.
Mine too. This one's great. You ever heard of Cassell?
I can't say I have.
Oh, well, he...
looks like this is us.
He boarded a train. At least she didn't get rid of her Neil Gaiman. I thought it was Gaiman. Oh. Then she said Anne Rand's wrong. Name wrong.
Two passengers. Well, this is my lucky day. It's freezing out here. You guys got on board old Gloria now. She's nice and warm. I'll come on and show you to your cabins momentarily. I'll just grab your luggage.
Gloria.
Off you go now.
Bossy.
Well, well. What's this then?
Huh? Stop messing
who's
with
that. Who's our cute little doggy?
Oh, I dropped that? Oh.
I know just who'll like this.
I thought that was her cigarette she dropped.
Settle down, you.
What the hell?
We're nearly ready. And if you start causing a scene now, I'll have to tell young Floyd what you've been up to. And we both know what'll happen then.
What?
That's it. There's a good boy. You just be a good wee writer and wait, watch, and listen like you always do.
A writer?
You'll be over soon, and you'll be back home before you know it.
Oh, wait, who brought that?
Aye, I reckon so.
What the hell? I literally don't know what happened in the last minute and a half. What the... what? Well, that's an heel. I guess now we're doing Sepulchre? Alright, so that final scene, what the hell with that? Now the dog, I thought he picked up the small dog, but then I thought there was a dog in the luggage. But then he said the guy in the the being in the luggage was a writer, and he's supposed to listen and write things or something. Then this crow comes by, lands on his shoulder, and goes, ah, and then he says, I understand, and then kills the crow and sticks it in his pocket. So whose luggage is that? I thought the luggage that wasn't Alex's was this other guy who was at the train station with her. I am very confused. So I'm assuming now we're playing Sepulchre? Yet the bookmark's in Exhale. I don't know if the bookmark is just always there. I don't notice one way or the other. So thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time when we play Sepulchre. Always, seek adventure.